Well, now we're looking at one of the hamstrings, and this one is put on here as a combination of semitendinosus and semimembranosus. The other of the three hamstrings is the biceps femoris, which I don't have you attaching necessarily, but I do want you to put one of the hamstrings on the skeleton, and this one goes from the ischial tuberosity, just like the biceps femoris. But instead of going laterally to the fibula, the semitendinosus and semimembranosus muscles attach more medially to the tibia, just distal, and a little bit lateral, just distal to the knee. And so these hamstrings all together would create knee flexion. So when I passively do that, you see them get more slack. And they've been cut intentionally long to allow full knee extension, especially if the knee is extended while the hip is flexed. So, hamstrings flex the knee, extend the hip, and they have to be long enough to allow full knee extension with hip flexion.